We expect to hear this morning that millions more Americans have filed unemployment claims because of the coronavirus. In Florida alone, nearly 600,000 people have applied for benefits since March 15th. Manuel Bojorquez shows how that state is struggling to process the surge, creating more uncertainty for people who need help.
This is a lifesaver.
David Guerrero arrived at a Miami area library Wednesday, one of the hundreds of thousands of Floridians now seeking unemployment benefits.
The system crashed and now we have papers to fill out, you know. If it goes out any longer, I mean, people are stressing on money.
That stress boiled over Tuesday when one application center in Miami's Hialeah neighborhood was overwhelmed.
I'm scared for my life.
Yeah, so we don't want the line. I mean, so social distancing is important.
On Wednesday, more distribution centers opened, and people were required to stay in their cars. Governor Ron DeSantis highlighted his government's efforts to scale up the state's online application system that crashed.
We've put a lot of servers in.
But there are also concerns about the benefits themselves. Florida caps weekly payments at $275, among the lowest in the U.S., and only offers assistance for 12 weeks. Most states offer twice that amount.
It was really a system that was designed not to help people.
Columnist Scott Maxwell of the Orlando Sentinel has written about Florida politics for more than 20 years. He says the problems originated under then-governor and now U.S. Senator Rick Scott.
Florida has the lowest corporate tax rate for unemployment taxes and the highest denial rate for unemployment benefits among workers.
You're saying that was by design?
Absolutely.
Told CBS News the insurance system and website vendor were selected before he was elected governor. Still, with all that uncertainty there with filing those claims, that's just adding to the delays for so many who need immediate relief. Gail?
All right. Thank you, Manuel.